It appears investors haven't been scared off the property market, borrowing almost $2.6 billion last month. According to the latest Reserve Bank data, first home buyers borrowed less than a third of that. Investors are now borrowing roughly $700 million more than they were at this time last year. Green Party co-leader Metiria Turei isn't happy with the situation. She joins us now. Good morning.
Kia ora.
Thanks for joining us, Metiria Turei. Now, we're just talking about the level of investors in the property market, still very, very strong. What is it that you would do to, try to get more investors out of the market and allow more first home buyers in?
It's a medium and long term strategy. I mean, what the data is showing us is that in the last 3 months, we've had the highest level since the Reserve Bank has been collecting data on this of investors borrowing over first time home buyers. So this number, around 7,000 investors a month versus less than 2,000 first home buyers, that's been pretty consistent for the last three months or so. And it's at the highest level. So nothing that government has done yet has worked to cool the investment. So let's just have a think about what they haven't done and what they should. One of those things is a more comprehensive capital gains tax that extends much longer than 2 years. 2 years just simply isn't long enough. And, you know, we've been arguing about this for more than a decade, that this is what's necessary. It would have a good short-term effect, but you also need other measures to make sure that the good impact lasts over a long period of time. We've always said that we should have a restriction on purchasing residential property to permanent residents and to citizens. And I think whether that was something you put in place for the long term or whether you put it in place for a few years, then at least it's one of the ways of helping to cool overseas investment. We also need to get rid of the tax exemptions. There's still two major ones, particularly one called combined collateral exemption, which allows big investors to use their equity across their whole property portfolio to get around the LVR rules. And that really only applies to those big investors. And so they have this huge advantage that they can get around the rules of the Reserve Bank.
Do you agree that housing in New Zealand is unaffordable at the moment?
Yes, I do. And I mean, this is, I think everybody does. You'd be completely bonkers not to.
Yeah, so which leads to the question.
Yep, ask it.
I will, and I think you know it's coming.
Yeah, I know it's coming.
Yeah, and it needs to be answered. Yep. Do you want house prices to drop?
Yes. Let's stop.
By about roughly what?
Well, I mean, this we just
because you got in trouble, last time.
Yeah,
you
I did.
Said this.
I did.
And
I did.
You
get
and
in
I
trouble.
Remember this.
Yeah,
we remember
this
it well.
Very
so,
well.
And you've thought about this. So this is pretty interesting and significant in my view that you've said this right now. And good on you for being up front. You're saying that you want house prices to drop. And
in my
recollection, you are the only politician I have heard say this in recent times, because even Labour, they won't say it. So you are saying that you want prices to drop roughly by what?
We would like to see them come down to something closer to 3 or 4 times the median household income.
Let's look at these figures because it's important.
Yes,
it's $1 million at the moment for an Auckland property.
Yes.
Right, it's a 1-to-10 ratio. You would be taking you're going down the Don Brash track of 40. I'm not, let's not politicize Don Brash, but you're talking about a 40-50% drop in house prices
over a long period
Aren't
of time.
You?
Yep, and so we.
I'll let you go, but I just want to clarify this.
The time frame Let me just describe this. So the time frame is critical, because what you do not want and what everybody is trying to avoid is any kind of bursting of the bubble, right? Because families will be the ones who get hurt. So the only way to manage this sensibly for families is to have a long-term plan that sets a reasonable target for household income.
I'll give you a couple more minutes on this, but firstly, let's just clarify this. You are saying this morning, And you can tell us your time frame, but you want house prices to drop 40 to 50% in Auckland by under what sort of time?
This is part of the piece of work that I'm doing right now, actually, and looking at all of the policy and all of the different ideas from different people. So, for example, we have a great report from the Chief Economist from Auckland Council who's talking about 5 times by 2030. That's one time frame that needs to be looked at, and the policy framework has been set out. It's quite a comprehensive report about how you could get there, right, and the role of council and the role of government. So this is why we mustn't allow us, me or you as media, to get alarmist about this. We need to have a comprehensive plan that looks at making housing affordable for families. Now, we know it's not affordable now, so the only way to prevent a bust and to protect families in the short and long term is to lay out a comprehensive plan, which means using every possible tool that we've got to slowly, over time, bring down house prices so they are reasonable, without necessarily making interfering too much with the value of people's lending. What we don't want is people getting into trouble with their mortgages. That is absolutely not acceptable, which is why you need a plan.
So is it fair to say then that you want that drop of 40 to 50% to occur over a decade or so? Is that what you're talking about?
Well, this is why I'm saying I'm doing the work now to have a look at the different timeframes that different analysts and economists and organisations are talking about to try to bring that work together. But what we don't have right now is a government that's even admitting that there's a problem, let alone putting in place a plan to deal with it to protect families. That is my commitment. Yeah. That is what I want to do. But it can't be done in an alarmist way. And it can't be done too quickly because we have to bring together all the information we've got.
Do you reckon you can convince Andrew
Little? Well, we'll be talking with everybody about this at a point where we have all of the information together that sets out what kind of plan is actually reasonable, and work with the whole industry. We've got to work with investors. We've got to work with bankers. This is not a single... This is why I'm really concerned about kind of the language around this. We mustn't be alarmist about it. We need a plan. And the plan means being real about the problem and working carefully with the whole of the New Zealand community to figure out how to roll that plan out over time.
All right. Thank you so much for your time.
Sweet
really appreciate it.
Kilda.
It's Metiria Turei.